afternoon to the faculty at various institutions. I will like to introduce Preeti Kumari. She has done M.Tech from NIT Agartala and is pursuing her PhD in Electrical Engineering Department at NITER. Her area is biomedical instrumentation. She has also published one review paper in Elsevier Science Journal, and she is doing work using LTEX software only. So she will just demonstrate how you can use this software for writing of your thesis report or even for your various research papers also. So I request her to interact with you.
Very good afternoon to all of you. All the participants are different centers. As ma'am already introduced me, so let us start with the today's topic, LaTeX. LaTeX is actually a very vast topic, which we cannot discuss each and every details in this short duration. So in this session, we will discuss only the basics of LaTeX. But I'm sure that will be sufficient for anyone to start working with LaTeX. So first of all, you must know what is LaTeX, why we are going to learn this, and why it is so important, what are the advantages of this software, of this programming language over other document preparation systems. So LaTeX, which is pronounced as LaTeX or LaTeX, is a text-based document preparation system. Is a basically a document preparation system just like MS Word. Okay, a text-based means text as here you can see is a original programming language which have powerful programming capability which facilitate LaTeX for different formatting in your document. LaTeX includes features designed for the production of medium to large technical and scientific documentations. Why we are saying medium to large? Because for small documents, LaTeX will not be a good option. Because even if you have to write small document, you have to write different, you have to write two or three more commands. So that's why for small documents, MS Word will be a good option. But for large documents, LaTeX will be a very good option. So LaTeX is a standard for communication and publication of scientific documents. And it can be used for almost any form of publishing. So in LaTeX document, mainly it will be a plain text file with some additional commands which helps in formatting for our document. LaTeX is not a word processor. You know, in MS Word, as we write, MS Word is also a document preparation system. So in that, in MS Word, we write our content as well as we have to take care about the appearance of the document. But here in LaTeX, you have to write only the content. Only author should have to focus only on the content, write content of the document. Rest the appearance will be taken care of by the LaTeX only. So the quality of document improves. For installation, you have to start working, you have to install two softwares. One is MiGTeX, another one is Text Editor. MiGTeX basically provides packages for LaTeX, which helps in formatting process of the document. And next is Text Editor for LaTeX, where we edit our content of the document. So Text Editor can be Text Studio, Technique Center. All this can be easily downloaded from Google. These are open source software, so you can download and you can work. So MiGTeX, you can download from MiGTeX.org. Now, what are the advantages of LaTeX over MS Word? Because from many years, we are used to of MS Word. So why to go for LaTeX? First, we must know what are the advantages of this. So in MS Word, whenever you have to write some document, you have to take care about the content as well as the formatting. But here, LaTeX will take care about all the formatting process. You don't have to do manually adjustment for font, text size, text flow for readability or for any for any appearance, you don't have to take any pain, any effort you don't have to give. So document structure is visible to the users and easily copied to any other document. Once we have written some written commands for the formatting in one document, the same command can be used for other documents. It can be easily copied. Next thing, next very important thing is LaTeX do the formatting for us, for our document. Also, the formatting is very consistent throughout the document. Without giving any effort, the formatting will be consistent. The LaTeX was first built for mathematical formulae. So mathematical formulae can be easily typeset in LaTeX. Also, indexes, footnotes, citation, and references, all these things can be easily generated. Then, as I told, there are different text editors for LaTeX. That is Text Technic Center or Text Studio. So once we write the source code for one text editor, the same source code can be will work for different editors also. So this gives us flexibility. So here you can say that in LaTeX, you are forced to instruct your document correctly. You are not giving any extra effort, still your document will look good. You are just focusing on your document content, still your document will look good without giving any extra effort. So you are forced to instruct your document correctly. Then comes common elements of writing. Whenever you are going to write some document, what can be the common elements? The common elements will be text, figures, tables. Then you may use bullets. You may have references. Then in text, you have to take care about the colors, font sizes, special characters, paragraphs, sections, table of contents. So all these things we can have in LaTeX also. We will see one by one. So now let us start with the LaTeX program. So the first step, whenever you are going to write any document, what will be the first thing? First thing, you must know what is the document class. Means what actually you are going to write. The document, is it article or is it report or is it a thesis or it may be an application. So according to the document class, you will use different formatting. So here also in LaTeX, first you have to define document class for your document. Then accordingly, LaTeX will do the formatting. So here, to define the document class, the command is first in LaTeX. Always, whenever you are going to write any command, you have to use backslash. Here you can see the backslash. Then after backslash, you have to write document class. Then in curly braces, you have to define the classes. That class can be article, can be report, can be book, can be memoir, can be slides. In document class, there can be some additional options. Like you can define the font size, that is here, as you can see, the 10 point, 11 point or 12 point. By default, it's 12 point. Then you can write it's a final draft or it's a final document or it's a draft. You can define the paper size, say A4 size or letter size. Or you can write here two-sided paper document or it's a one-sided. It can be one column or two column. In this way, there may be different options. Here you can see all the optional commands will be in square bracket. And the mandatory commands will be in curly braces. Here, this square bracket commands are optional. You can leave that. Also, you can combine more than one command with commas in the square bracket itself. Then, after defining the document class for any document, you have to write another command backslash begin, then in curly braces document. For any LaTeX document, this will be the common things. So here, this is the absolute minimal LaTeX document for LaTeX. The first thing, we have defined the document class, then begin, then slash begin document. After that, you have to write the content of your document. Here in box, I have written the content of the document, which is hello there. In your document, only this will be printed. So if you want to print this hello there, you have to write this fourth command, then only this will print. That's why I told that for small documents, LaTeX is not a good option. If you have to write, you have to print just these two words, no need to write this four commands. You can write easily these two words. But if the document is large and you have to take care about the appearance, about the formatting, in that case, LaTeX will be a better option. Content of the document, you have to write backslash end, then in curly braces document. So whenever you are beginning something, you have to end that. So here, whenever we use backslash begin and backslash end, so this is called an environment in LaTeX. So begin, then curly braces document means it's a document environment. So whatever you have to print in a document, that you have to write in document environment only. So after that, if you write anything below this end document, this will not be printed in your document. This will be ignored by the LaTeX. Okay. Here there may be some additional things. First thing, you have to define the document class for any LaTeX document. Then, if you are using different colors in your document, in that case you have to use different packages. Like here, there are different. If you are using color, you have to use backslash use package curly braces color. As I told, this MikTeX provides packages for the LaTeX. So here, MikTeX will provide these packages for different applications. Also, if you are using figures in your documents, so you have to use package graphics. So these things, according to your application, you can use different packages. All these things will come before begin document, and that is called preamble. Then after begin document, you will write the content of the document and then end document. So this hello there is actually text of your document. Rest thing is used only for the formatting. Then comes sentences and paragraphs. Always, whenever you write some documents, there will be sentence, there will be paragraphs. So in that case, whenever you are writing documents in Word document, you have to take care about the spacing, you have to take care about the indentation, you have to take care about the paragraphs. So, but in LaTeX, what you have to write here, just here in blue colors, you can see this is the content what the author have written in document environment. Okay, so here you can notice this unnecessary space between two words, this interword space which is unnecessary, which is actually not required, but author have written is randomly without taking care about these spaces. Here also you can see here the vertical spaces between two para, okay, which is actually unnecessary, but author is not taking care about it. Author is only writing the content. But when we run the program, LaTeX program, LaTeX will print this, which is given here in boxes. Here you can see LaTeX has already omitted this unnecessary space between two words and between two para. So this is the beauty of LaTeX, where we don't have to take care about this small formatting. Also, when we are giving the vertical spaces between two para, LaTeX will understand that it can be two different para. So it will give the indentation before first word. You can see here, and also you can notice that the indentation for both the para is exactly equal. We have not given any extra effort for this, but it will give this indentation by itself. Okay. Next, sometimes it's the need of your document. You want this vertical spacing in your document between two para. So in that case, you have to use this double backslash. Double backslash is actually command for new line. So double backslash, then in square bracket, you will give the spacing, like the measurement. This is here given 0.2 centimeter. So according to your application, you can give here the spacing, and here you can see the space. Again, here another command is here. In LaTeX document, in the document environment, here I have written backslash, then footnote, then in curly braces talking about footnotes. So whenever we are using backslash, means it's a command. It will not be printed in your document. Here you can see this is the printed document from LaTeX. So here this backslash footnote is not written, but here one, you can see here one appears. So whenever you are using this footnote command first time for your document, then one will appear here. And the footnote, the curly braces, you have written the talking about footnote. This is the footnote comment actually. So this will be written here in the footnote. If you'll use this footnote command for the second time, automatically here two will appear. You don't have to give any extra effort for this. Again, in the document environment, whenever you will use this percentage sign, so it will consider this as a comment. This is not a command. This is not the content of the document, but this will be a comment. So LaTeX will not print this. You can see here, this is a comment. This is not printed in a LaTeX document. Now, as I told, whenever you will write a command in later document, you have to use backslash. But sometimes in our document, we need to print that backslash symbol. So in that case, there are some 10 special characters for which if we want to use these characters to print these characters in our document, you have to use the symbols like this. If you have to print hash, you have to write backslash, then hash, backslash, then dollar. In this way you will write, then only this symbols will be printed in your document. And about the backslash, you have to write backslash, then text backslash, then it will print backslash. Otherwise, whenever you will use backslash, it will not print this, and it will consider the next word as a command. After that, for any document, you may have to build a title page for your document. So in that case, if you have to build a title page like this in the Word document, you have to give this spacing manually. You have to take care about this size, font size manually. Then this size and this size, all these things you have to take care manually. You have to give, you have to set the size and spacing manually in Word document. But here in LaTeX, you have to just give command slash backslash title. Then in curly braces, you have to write the title of the document. Okay. After that, backslash author. In curly braces, you will write the author names. Again, backslash date, you will write the date. After that, you have to write backslash make title. Then LaTeX will build this title page for you. You have to just write the title for your document, author name, and the date. Rest things, spacing and size, it will automatically adjust. Automatically, it will adjust that title should be bigger than the author name, and rest accordingly it will adjust. So here you can see, you don't have to give any extra effort. You have to just write. Rest thing LaTeX will take care. In title, you can see here, like if you want A should be in caps or C should be in caps, you have to write as it is in curly braces. It will print as it is. Only it will take care about the font size. Style, you have to take care. Then comes sections. So for section, the command is backslash section. Then in curly braces, you have to write the section title. Also, there are some other commands. You can have subsections. You can have sub-sections. Then you can have paragraphs, sub-paragraphs, chapters. So this is the example. Here, backslash section, then in curly braces, this is the section title. Then the content of the section is written here. After that, again, backslash subsection, then in curly braces, title of the subsection. And here you can see similar way. When we run the program, LaTeX will print like this. Here you can see the size of the section title is bigger than the subsection title, and this is bigger than the content of the section. Content of the section. So here you are not defining anywhere what should be the title, what should be the size of the section title, what should be the title for the subsection title, and what should be the title, what should be size for the content, and what should be the spacing between these two. All these things are taken care by the LaTeX only. We are not giving any extra effort. You are just writing the content, and LaTeX is printing according to the requirement. Again, sometimes if you want the section title, if for example sometimes section title is very bigger and you don't want to print that bigger title in your table of content, so in that case we can use some additional command. So first thing to make table of content, the command is slash table of content. If you write slash table of content and you will print that, you will run the program, you will see here the content as shown here. But in Word, you have to give some extra effort to make the table of content. And every time we have to update. In Word also, you have the commands for table of content, but every time you have to update that, here it will be automatically updated. Again here, like as I told, here the section title is very bigger, Earth's Most Intelligent Animals. But you want to print only Earth Intelligence in the table of content. So in that case, Earth Intelligence will be written in square bracket, and then the actual section title will be in curly braces. So here you can see the Earth's Most Intelligent Animals, which is the actual section title, will be printed here in the document, and the art intelligence will be printed in the content. So always, whenever you are writing the square bracket, that is optional, which you can use and you cannot use. Same thing is here also in subsection and in different sections. After that, for the margin of the paper, here you have to use package text. Then you have to first have to define the size of the paper. Then you can define the top margin, left margin, and you have to give the command in curly braces geometry. Another can be if you want equal margin for all four sizes. So here you have to define the paper size and then centering. Then all the margins will be same for all four sizes. Then sometimes we want spacing between two words. So in that case, here the command is / h space, means it is horizontal space. Then you can define the space, in how much space you want. Like this can be 5 mm, this can be 10 mm. So accordingly, here you can see space between the two words. Also for vertical spaces, here the command is / v space, then 1 cm. So here 1 cm vertical space you can notice here. Sometimes if you will write here, sometimes if you will use this command / h space and then the amount of the spacing, in the beginning of the sentence it will not give the space, as here you can see here. But if you will use the star mark with this h space, then it will show this space at the beginning also. Same thing here, another command is / h fill. So here you don't have to give the measurement how much space you want to give, it will adjust automatically. Another is dot fill, it will fill by the dotted lines, dot, and here h rule, so that it will be underline space between the two words. Again here also, if you will use the star mark, so it will use, then it will be print, and then the space will be printed before sentences also. After that, the formatting, that there may be different text styles. So for that, different commands are there. For italic, you have to use /text it. Then in curly braces, the word which you want to print in italic. Okay, only this, the word which is written in curly braces, which will be printed in italic style. Here you can see. Also the command next is /underline. Then in curly braces, underlined text. So here underlined will be underlined only. So whatever text you want in this style, you have to write that contain in the curly braces, then it will be print as it is. After that, as I told you, if you want different colors in your document, so you have to use different packages. You can use package color, or you can use X color. So command is here, you have to here you can write this text in curly braces /color, then in curly braces blue is in blue, then again curly braces close. You can see the format, the syntax here. Okay, so after /blue, the word is written, the sentence is written is in blue, so that is written in blue color. You can see here, which will be printed in blue color, is in blue. Okay, different formatting is here. You can write /text color, then you have to define the color. After that, in curly braces separately, you will write the words which we want in different color. So here you can see in different colors. By default, it will take the black color. Otherwise, you can define. Then comes the size of the font. One thing we have already discussed, you can define in the document class. It can be 10 point, 11 point, 12 points. In other way, you can also define the text sizes. That can be /teeny, if you want the text with text is very small, then /script size, footnote size, small, all are comparable. You can use, and then you can see whatever size you want, accordingly you can use. Sometimes you can define your own size, your own font size also. The command is /def, means define, then /myteeny or my whatever name you want to give. Then in curly braces, /font size, you can define your font size. Then /select font, curly braces close. So you can define your own size. If using this command you are not getting the actual size which you want, so in that case you can define here also. Then next comes itemize or bullets. In many times in our documents you need to use this bullets or numbers in your documents. So in that case, here this is the complete complete LaTeX document. So first thing you have to define the document class. Here I have already defined the paper size. Then begin document. Means the document environment has been already started. After that, for itemize, you have to start again different environment, that is itemize. So backslash begin itemize you have to write. Then you have to define different itemize styles. Here we have used bullet, C dots, diamond shape, or asterisk shape. So here the command is backslash renew command, then in curly braces backslash level item 1. Level item 1, here this is the first level, so for that we have defined bullets. Next, renew command level item 2, in Roman it is written 2, so the bullet style is C dot, so it will be a circular dot, okay, for the second level. Then for the third level it is diamond shape, so here third level means inside that. So this is the third level, this is diamond shape. Then again this is first level, that's why it's the bullet. Again here what should be the, this is, here we have defined the style for the bullets, for the items. But what will be the content of the levels? So here it is written, first item, slash item, first level, first item. This is just the examples, you can, here it can be any content, whatever you want to write. Then again, if since it's a second level, means it is again itemized within that itemized. So this is nested environment. So here first we have used begin itemize. So this will print first item. First item we have used, first begin itemize. Then within that first item, second is begin itemize. So this will be the item, this will be the second level. So in second level we have written two sentences. So for that circular dot is used. Again within that second level, third level is used. That's why again you have to start begin itemize. Then the third level you can write. In third level also we have two contents, two sentences. So here this is written two sentences. After that we have not used fourth level. Still here we have defined bullet style for the fourth level also, asterisk style. But we are not using here. So for the third level, which is innermost, so for that we have started this begin itemize, so you have to end that begin itemize. Then for the second one we have started begin itemize, we have to end that begin itemize. Then again here we have written, for the first level we have written another item, so here another item is written, then end itemize. So here you can see these two are for one environment, one itemize environment, these two are for second itemize environment, and this end is for the first itemize environment. Okay, so all three environments are closed now. Then you have to use this end document. So whenever you are beginning any environment, you have to end that. Okay, another thing, sometimes you can use ordered listing. So here you have to define same package, same thing, in the same way you have to use different package here. The different package is enumerate and color. Color I have used because here we want the bullets in different color. If you don't want to use different color, so no need to mention this color package. Then same way you have to start the document environment. Then another environment will be enumerate. This is just the packages used for different applications. So enumerate, then the command is in square bracket, again the curly braces, backslash color. Color is red, you can define here color. Then in backslash bf is for bold faces, because these bullets are bold faces, the command is bf. Then what bullet style you want, what number, it is a dot. If you write your one dot, so it will automatically print 1, 2, 3. Here we have started a dot, so it is a b c. Okay, so backslash bf is for bold faces, backslash color is for color, and here we have defined the red color. And then A dot is for the ordered style. Then what will be the content of the item? So first item, first, then the second item, and the third item. Here you can see battery.
ये सेम लेक्चर्स डेंट से सेम लग रहा है.
So here you can see at the time of writing the program, I have given this space. Here, the first item is backslash item, then the first item, backslash item, these are aligned with, these two are aligned, but the third one is not aligned. But still, whenever you will run the program, LaTeX will print with the same alignment. Because this here, same item, same level item, so this should be aligned. If this is a second level item, then this should be, this would be inside this first level. Again, since we have started, we have started one environment, we have to end that and enumerate, then end document, LaTeX will print. So this is the output of this program. This is the complete program to just print these three bullets. Next, as I have already told that we can use nested itemized. So here also this is another example. First, just in begin document you have to write begin itemized, then the first item. This is the second item for the first level. Then within that begin enumerate means this is combination of bullets and the ordered listing. So first here we have defined the triangular shape here as you see in the output here. So first level and the third level, which is triangular bullet, and then in begin enumerate, whenever you will use the enumerate means it's the ordered listing. So here first item number 1, item number 2, item number 3. So here you can see the output is 1, 2, 3 bullets are. Then again within that begin itemize, first item dollar shape, then backslash square shoot dollar shape, then square bracket close. So here you can see this is another shape, square shoot, then heart shape, then diamond shoot, then club. So for different shapes you can use this shapes also you can use for bullets in your documents. So again this is nested. So this and this we have started the begin we have started the itemize environment that should be ended. Again end enumerate, because this itemize environment was inside that enumerate, inside that third point number 3. So that's why first this should be closed, then this should be ended, enumerate should be ended, after that the last item, then end itemize. So this is also the example of just nested bullets. Next comes figures. Whenever you have to use figures, insert figures in your document. So in LaTeX, in the same way, first thing you have to define the document class. Here, as you can see here, you have defined document class. This is article and the font size. After that, as I told, whenever you have to insert figures, you have to use package graphics. So here, use package graphics. Then document environment will be started. You have to start another environment, figure. So backslash begin figure, end figure. Within that you have to write this command. First is backslash centering. This is used for if you want the figure, if figure should be centered, so then you will use this. Otherwise it will be left aligned or it can be right aligned. Then backslash include graphics. If you have some figures in your system, so you want to include that graphic in your document. That's why the command is include graphics. After that, what should be the dimensions of the figure? Here you can define what should be the width, what should be the height. Then that should be written in square bracket. Already as I told, whenever you are writing square bracket, these are the optional. You can leave this blank also. Means if you will not define this the dimensions, it will take something default sizes. And then next is in curly braces, you have to define the name of the document, name of the figure, which name, the same name with you have saved your file, your figure, the same name you have to write here. After that, backslash caption in curly braces, you can write some caption. If you will not give caption name, like as I written here, this is blank. So here you can see this is written figure one colon, but there is no caption. So this is blank. If you want to write something, you can write here in curly braces. After that, backslash level, curly braces, figure colon garden one. Garden one is actually the name of your figure. Name of the figure which you have saved your this file in your system. So this level is actually used when you want to refer this figure in your text. Obviously, whenever you are using some figures in your document, you will refer that like in figure one you are showing this, in figure two you are showing this. So in that case, in Word, if you are writing, you have to write manually that in figure one you want to show this. But in LaTeX, you will use figure.garden1 or maybe some other thing, some other name, whatever you want to write here. So automatically it will count, it will detect that this is figure 1 or this is figure 2. You have to write this level and it will automatically detect the figure 1 or 2, whatever it is. Okay. Then another style can be, you can start figure environment. Then same thing, centering, include graphics. You can define only the width. And the next, the caption level. Same thing, since as you can see here, I have defined width and height. So figure dimension is something else. Here I have defined only width. So figure dimension is something different. You can see here, other thing both are same. But here, if your figure, like whenever you are start working with LaTeX, you must have one folder for LaTeX. So this figure should be saved in that LaTeX folder only. Then only you can use this command. Okay. If the figure is in some different folder other than that LaTeX folder, then you have to define the path where is the figure. So in that case, with use package, you have to use another command, backslash graphics path. In the preamble, you have to define the path for your file, for your figure. So command is double curly braces. Then you have to define the path the same wherever you have saved your file. Here you can define here. After that, same thing. Rest things are same. The figure environment is exactly same. Include graphics, centering, caption. Here I have given the caption beauty. So here you can see figure one colon beauty. After that, end figure and end document. Okay. So if your figure is within the LaTeX folder, you don't have to give this path. Otherwise, you have to define the path. Next comes tables. In tables also, just like in figures, here also you have to start another environment, that is table. So here, begin table. Then first command is backslash caption. So there, for any table, you must have to give some captions. So here, backslash caption. Performance. This is in this example, this is written performance. After that, centering. These commands are optional actually. You can use here and different alignments also. After that, backslash begin tabular. Then in curly braces here you can see the command is C. Then this vertical line C. This is used for centering. Like the items, the content of the different rows and different columns should be centered. So here you will write C. If you want this right alignment, so you can write here right. If you want left alignment, then you have to write here L. Okay. Then comes the items. What are the content of the table? So here, for different rows, you have to use double backslash. And for the different columns, you have to do the ampersand sign. So here, the first item is CD, video, and table. CD, video, and total. These are the items for the first column. So here you can see, and the second is cost. Third one is quantity. So same way you can see here. different columns are separated by ampersand, different rows are separated by double backslash. Then you have to use this end tabular. Here also you have started one environment, you have to end that environment. Then backslash level tab colon h results. Here it is just the name of the table, whatever you want to refer in the text. If you don't want to refer this, you can leave this command. You can omit this command. After that, in table, in document. So to print this table, you have to write in the same way, different environment, the tabular environment and the table environment. Okay. Now, as I written here, C, then this vertical line, C, this vertical line, that's why you are seeing this vertical line. If you write only C, 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 then this vertical lines will disappear. Next is equations. In any document, you may have some equations. So for that, you can have different environments. Within document environment, there may be different formattings according to your application. Like in this example, you can see one style is you can use within text, you can use double dollar sign, then your equation, then double dollar sign with that will be closed. And after that, your content of the document. So this will print like this. You can see here. If you use double dollar sign, so this the equation will be separated from the text. But here, if you will see here, then in the last section, with the text we have used the command backslash. Then in small bracket the equations are written. So this will be. This will be written with the text only. This equation is not separated from the text. So for different appearance, there may be different commands. Again, here there may be some different the different style also. Like here, you can use different environment. Begin display math, and then you can write the equation. Then end math. Obviously, you are beginning something. You have to end again. Next can be this begin math and then again end math. You can see whenever you are using different style, you will have a different appearance. So for display math, you can see this is separated from the text. Whenever you are using only math, this is within the text only. Okay. Another thing you may have like equation numbers. So for numbered equations, you have to use begin align. If you use begin align and end align, so in that case here, since here we are talking about the alignments, so here y is equal to, so this will be treated as a table. So in table, as I told, different columns will be separated by ampersand and different rows will be separated by the double backslash. So here for columns, here y, then ampersand, then equal sign. After that, you will write the equation, whatever equation you want to write. The double backslash means different row will be started. Then ampersand means another column. Since we are using alignment, so here you will see this alignment. Okay, means these two equations are aligned. Means both are actually y. Y is equal to this. Y is equal to this. Okay. Then after this equation, we have written backslash no tag. So whenever you are using align environment, so for every equation you will have one equation number. But since in the second equation we don't want the equation number, that's why we have written no tag. Backslash no tag means it will not be tagged as the equation number. Okay. Then end align and end documents. Okay. Again, this is also same thing. If you want equation numbers and you want to refer those equations in your text, like in equation number one from equation number one. So in that case, you have to use, like here, begin equation. This is another environment. Begin equation, and then equation whatever equation you want to write. Then backslash level in curly braces my tag. Means whatever equation number will be here, like if it's equation number one, so whenever you will refer this, like in this sentence, here you can see bat class EQREF means equation reference. Then in curly braces my tag, you can write here something else also. So my tag, so if you are writing my tag, so if the equation number for this equation is 1, it will appear here 1. If equation number is 2, it will appear here 2. As you can see here, for this equation, equation number is 1. So in text, it is written only 1. Okay. So you are not giving this, giving a first for this, what is the equation number, what was the equation number for that equation. You can just write that my tag, it will automatically detect. Like this is an example. First thing, you have to define the document class. Then the package you can omit. If you are using this, using figures, then only you will use this package. After that, whenever you want to refer something, you want some papers, you want to refer some papers in your document. So in that case, the command is backslash cite, C-I-T-E, backslash cite. Then in curly braces, you have to write some code. From where this code is coming, that will show you. Okay, same way here. So in this document, we have cited 3 documents. And after that, you have to use backslash bibliography style. What should be the style of the reference whenever you will run the program? So here the style is abbreviation. Then backslash bibliography, there will be a BibTeX file in LaTeX. So what is the name of that BibTeX file that is written here? So when we will run this, then you will see this output. We have cited 3 documents, so automatically it has already detected 1, 2 and 3, and references are already built here. Now the question is, from where we are getting this course? So for that, so here this is the text studio. As I told, the text editor for the LaTeX. So here the screen for the text studio. Here I have written this example. Different examples also. अच्छा यहाँ से न्यू जूम नहीं होती, हाँ पर ये जूम हो रही है ना, ये कोडिंग जूम नहीं होती. रीडेबल है सर, दिख रही है? ओके, सो दिस इज द टेक्स्ट स्टूडियो एडिटर विंडो. So here, as I shown you this example already, here as I told, whenever you are writing, like this is one example document. Okay, first time you will write this. For example, you have written these examples, this program, this LaTeX document. You have to click this build and view. You will run this. And here this is the output. Okay, now here the output will be in PDF format. Okay, so this is the complete document. You can see the outside also. Here this is the external viewer. If you click here, so from here you can see we have just used table of content one command. Here backslash table of content, okay, and of the table of content you can see here. This is very nicely the font size, spacing, all these things are automatically generated. We are not taking over anything else. Here you can see one difference. For example, these are the chapters 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 7. But the last one, the number is not appearing. But still, this is showing in the table of content. So for that, obviously, references are not numbered. But still, you want to see in that in your document. So for that, you have to write one command. as we have written. You can use section, then asterisk sign. If you will use asterisk sign before the title of the section, then it will not show the number. Okay, and still it will be included in the content of the table. So that's why here the number is not showing, but it is showing the table of contents. Rest, already just we have defined the sections. This is section, this is subsection. Size is automatically LaTeX is deciding. Okay, the respective size, this should be bigger, this should be smaller, this should be smaller. All these things are taken care by the LaTeX only. Here you can see all the spacing. Then comes figures. Like in figure 1, what we have written here. Yes, block diagram, this one. So here, figure. Here, whenever you will write backslash, then figure, after that you will write this square bracket H. So if you write square bracket H, so this means here. You want to print the figures here only. Otherwise, sometimes when in Word, whenever we insert some figures, so sometimes the text, when once we have written the document, after that you want to add some text, sometimes figure comes down in the next space and then the unnecessary space created. So in that case, LaTeX what it does that it automatically adjusts the text, maybe above the figure, maybe below the figure, but the space, unnecessary space will not be appear. So it automatically adjusts. Sometimes you want your figure should be here only. You don't want to move that figure up above or below. So in that case, you can use this square bracket H. H means here. If you will not use this, then LaTeX will adjust automatically figure in above the page or in below page. Okay. Then here the include graphics, captions, and the level, as already here we are seeing. This is the complete document. The text editor, only few commands are used. After that, document is looking completely perfect. We have used just few commands here, the document class and the package. In package, we are just defining the margin. What are the paper size? What are the margins? What are the bottom margin, top margin? Okay. Then here the paragraph indentation. These are the optionals. What is the paragraph indentation? If you want to define yourself, then here some measurement is given 5 ex. Otherwise, it will take automatically some standard length. Then here this is used renew command. Baseline stretch 1.5. And what should the line spacing? Standard is 1.5. We use normally line spacing. So here we can define. Otherwise, you cannot. So just for better look, we have used two to three more commands. Otherwise, here you can see only the content is written. Only the content of the documents are written. These are all the contents of the document. No more commands. Still, document is looking perfect. Okay. Here also, this was the example what we have shown here. Okay, so this was the example what we are talking about, the references and citations. Okay, same thing, same document, same LaTeX document here we have run, and this is the output. The question is, from where we will get this quotes, Agarwal, this and this HN. For that, you have to build one BibTeX file. As I told here, one BibTeX file here we have used synopsis. So from where we will take that. First thing, we can export BibTeX file from different sources. One example is Mendeley. Like if you have the Mendeley software, or there are different softwares also in MS Word, like there are Zotero and Aurora we can use. And one very user friendly is Mendeley, that's why we are using that. So in Mendeley, like for example, folder synopsis. So we want, you want to export or export these papers in different BibTeX file. For example, we want to export these three papers in BibTeX file. So we have selected these three with the control key. Then go to file. Then here export. Automatically here the save as type is coming BibTeX. So here you can give the name. For example, my collection one I have given. It is automatically saved in, you can see, LaTeX folder. If it is not the default path, you will select this same path. You have to save this BibTeX file in the LaTeX folder only. Okay, so my collection one, save. Go to LaTeX folder. Then you can see here my collection one, a BibTeX document is already created. Okay, so if you will open this my collection one from here in the Text Studio, you can see from the open, you will go to that LaTeX folder. Then my collection one, open. Then this BibTeX file will be opened. You can see this, we have selected three papers. So three citations are coming, one, two, and the third one is here. Okay. So these are already, BibTeX has already exported information of the paper. Here you can see the author name. Then this is the path of the file. Then what is the title? Okay, here also sometimes it already extracted the abstract of the paper, then author, DOI of the paper, then ISBN, ISSN. Whatever informations are already given in Mendeley, it is already exported in the BibTeX file also. So all these are informations of the papers, or the three papers what we have selected. So what you have to do is just create this BibTeX file. Whatever paper you want to cite in your paper, in your document, you have to build this BibTeX file. Then these are the codes, like here Agrawal 2014. So the first code, this is already given in different color. You can easily distinguish this Agrawal 2014, or here the last one is AHN 2016. Okay, so this code you have to write in your LaTeX document. What we have, / cite, after that in curly braces you have to write this code Agrawal 2014 AHN 2016. So whenever you will write this codes here, you will cite this codes here, then you have to write here the name of the file which you have saved in your here BibTeX file. Okay, so here / bibliography synopsis I have written here. Here you will write my collection one. Okay, just name here one. Synopsis is also a BibTeX file. So I have used here synopsis. That's why the name is synopsis. If you are using this BibTeX file, you will change the name here. Okay, here this is the BibTeX, the bibliography style abbreviation. This can be IEEE. There are different styles. So you can use this style, and accordingly you will see the output. Okay, here this is used for / add content line, then in curly braces TOC, then curly braces section, curly braces unknown. You can see here one section is India in this document, another is subsection is origin here, then another section is unknown, asterisk is given. That's why here the section number is not showing. Okay, but still, as I told, it will be included in the table of content. But if you don't want to include in table of content, then you will use this TOC, add content line TOC unknown, then it will not be showing table of content. Okay. After that, so this is all about the references and citations. So whatever, like here in synopsis, since we have cited only three papers here, so you are seeing here three references. Okay. Sometimes we have used these three papers. You have cited three papers. After that, you just notice that this second one is not relevant for your document. So you want to delete this. So you will delete this this paper, this code from here, this command/bat/site and this code, then here this will appear. This will disappear, like 1 and 2 will appear here and this 2 will be deleted. Still here you will see the three references. References will be still 3. So for that, what you have to do, why this 3 is coming, what you have to do for the correct references. Here you can see. Once we write one LaTeX document, then at least first time you have to run this document. Once we run, then you can see here there are different documents are coming with the same name text. I have written only one TEST. We have written only one test LaTeX document, but there are different files with the text, the same name, but the extension is different. You can see this is AUX file, this is BBL file, this is performing something, this is DVI file text document, and this is actually your PDF file, which is your output, and then WinZip file and this LaTeX document. This is your LaTeX document, which will be open in your editor. But these are the supporting documents. So for the references, as I told, if once you have cited 3 papers, and after that you want to remove one reference from your document. So in that case, just first close this output, close this PDF file. After that, delete all these supporting documents. Okay, apart from this LaTeX document, you have to just keep this LaTeX document. Here you can see here, this is written type LaTeX document. Okay, all these auxiliary files, the supporting documents with the same name, you have to delete. Okay, then after that, delete one citation which you want to remove. Then again run. Then you will run and again the supporting documents will be created. But these supporting documents will be updated document. And then here you will see the. Otherwise, what happens? Three papers. So already auxiliary files, the supporting files are created and they have created 3 references. So in that case, whenever, even if you have deleted this one reference, you are seeing the three references. So that's why you have to delete all these supporting documents. Then only you will see the updated references. Okay. So all these supporting documents. For example, here, as I told that this is the PDF document. You want to, if you will, you will change anything here, you will see same changes here also. Okay. Sometimes you want to keep this one also the some updated file also. Then in that case, you have to copy this PDF file and paste somewhere else in the document apart from this LaTeX folder. Then that will be and save this save the file with some other name. After that, you change in your LaTeX document in your code and you will see the difference. And then you will have the both final outputs. Otherwise, if you will copy this and paste here only, then it will be replaced with the same document. Okay. So this was all about the LaTeX. There are different application, like you can have fractions, just same as the equations. There may be some fractions. So there are command/fraction. Whenever you are using dollar sign, so this will be created. This will be treated as a equations. The dollar sign, you have to end that. These things come what window was coming. Actually, whenever you will run the program for the first time and you are using some packages in your document, so it will ask you want to install that package in your LaTeX document. So here you will click on this install. It will install that, like for example, AMS Math package will be installed and then it will show the result. Otherwise, it will not show. If the package is not available in your document, in your LaTeX software, then it will not work. Very useful thing is for LaTeX, whenever you are going to write some papers, some research papers. So in that case, in most of the journals, they give the LaTeX source code for the formatting. So in that case, all the formatting they have already given. Only thing, you have to write the content. It is given, you have to write your content, you have to copy your content there, and the papers will be completed. Otherwise, you know, whenever you are going to write some research paper, they give their own format for the paper, and to write the paper in the same format is very difficult thing. Always, whenever you change very small things, still the whole formatting will change, and you have to work again for that in Word. If you are working in MS Word, but in LaTeX, if they have given the source code, you have to just write the content. Automatically, the paper will be created. You don't have to do anything else. So this is very helpful for paper writing. And for the troubleshooting part, different, as I told, this is very common. You can search whenever you have any query, you can write in Google. You will get the results. Other than that, they have website CTAN. You will search in Google and you will get the results. Whenever you have any query, you will just write that word, the keywords, and it will show you the course in detail. Okay, they give the commands. You may have some disadvantages also whenever you are working with LaTeX. Like sometimes, as I told, you are forced to structure your. Sometimes it is difficult to obtain the certain look for your document. Like if you want some specific look for a document, so it may be difficult because it will adjust automatically. You want something else, it will adjust automatically what is correct word. But sometimes you don't want that correct thing. So this can be disadvantage. Also, sometimes, like at least first time you have to run, then only you can see what is the appearance of your document. Otherwise, you cannot see. Like in MS Word, you are writing and simultaneously you can see that what is the appearance of the document. But in LaTeX, first time at least you have to run. So first time for document will run only when your LaTeX document is it don't have any error. So you have to take care about that. If in the code, so it will not work, it will not run, so you cannot see how your document will appear. So in that case, this is also disadvantage of the LaTeX. But once you run, you can see. Okay, this is another example for table. As I told, here also for columns, you have to use ampersand. For rows, you have to use this double black backslash. If you want spacing between different rows, as in first example, we have not defined this spacing, so all these rows were very close to each other. If you want separation according to your application, so you can define here. So here also, in square bracket, we are giving the spaces, means this is optional. So here we have given the spaces. So you can see here. Also here, as I told, this vertical lines means here vertical lines are coming. Here we have written this after the caption. Double horizontal line we have written. We have given backslash H line. Backslash H line means this is horizontal line. So two times we have written this command H line, means two horizontal lines are coming. Okay, after the caption, then table has been started. Okay, then the table, the first the headings are audio name and the sum of the extracted bits. Here you can see same thing again. If we have written this H backslash H line is horizontal line, and after that backslash C line 1 to 7 means what should be the length of this horizontal line we have defined here. So this is 1 to 7, column number 1 to 7. Here we have not defined. So this, here you can see these lines are up to this only. This will be randomly selected. Okay, but if you will define this 1 to 7, so this will be up to 7th column. Okay. Here also we have defined the space between the rows. Like after that, after this headings, what will be the length distances? Fraction already I have told. there are different commands. You have to use this dollar sign, then backslash fract, then fraction. This is the numerator, this will be the denominator. Okay, sorry, this is numerator and this will be denominator. Okay, this is different style, defract. This is again the square backslash sqrt 27, means this is a symbol. If you want to print this square root sign, so the symbol is, the command is sqrt.